Hey everyone, Charles Dale here, and today I'm going to be reviewing part of a mod pack called Volts. This is going to be the ICBM mod. I'm not going to go over all the electronics and stuff, but I'm going to show you some explosions. So this is a shrapnel explosive. I'm going to do them in order of, like, level. Not exactly, but generally. So this one shoots flaming arrows in all directions, as you can see. Next would be the anvil explosives. It's the same thing but with anvils. Nothing. Just do that. Pretty powerful. Next, we have some missiles. I'm getting over, but you can pretty much launch them. This is an incendiary missile. Then we have this chemical missile. This one poisons and such. I was going to so you can see the effects that it gives you. So it gave me a chemical effect. This missile keep breaching explosives. This is a level 2. This is now just getting more fun. This is level 2 explosive. See, it's a simple explosive. Next we have a fragmentation missile. Well, I'm not actually going to show this one. Sonic missile, I can show this one. Fragmentation missile. It just makes a bunch of explosions. Small explosions. Kind of moves blocks, pretty much. Next, we get to some of the stronger explosions, but endothermic explosives. Hold on, is that I need to change the time? Great. This is a pretty cool one. I guess it gives me nausea. So yeah, as you can see, it just makes a bunch of ice. Okay. So next we have the anti-gravitation. Well, that does just makes things levitate. This warps you to the end. But I'll save that for last. No, no. that we've made that all icy, let's burn it to the ground. So these, I'm gonna make this after we go farther away. I almost forgot to do that because it has to be during the day to actually use this missile. On my mini map, it looks pretty brutal. I mean, this is setting everything on fire and lava. Just total destruction. And it's still going. This is why I moved away from my thing. Wait, I think it like actually changes it to night or something. Actually, insect claws all. Never mind. It's most of them. Yeah, let's go back to our thing. So. One missile left to show you, and then I get to show you some of the destructive, the most destructive one. This is, in my opinion, the best one. It's an anti-matter missile. Demonstrate the safe power. We're gonna go over here, guys. I wish I could like find a village. That'd be really epic because I'm not sure how strong this area is. Oh, this is supposed to place. I almost feel bad for this area. 2, 1. Fire. Now that is downright destruction. If you look on my mini map, you can see how big the crater actually is. Very, very big. And that's destructive, alright. Okay. Now. I need an antimatter explosive. Actually, no, I need another antimatter as well. Don't get another antimatter missile. You have a problem because then when I set off this next thing, it can just destroy the entire world. Unless I have an antimatter missile. So I'm going to fly over to my thing. We launch off the last and most powerful weapon of all. We'll see why in a second. We'll also see why I have loaded another one. So, our last explosion. The red matter explosives. This is no easygoing explosive here. ready our laser detonator. This just creates a black hole. But we'll keep going unless we don't finish it. It just grows and grows and grows. It's just like a single for a minute. I'm not sure, this thing might even be able to break through bedrock. Actually, maybe the internet was a strong. Depends. The nice thing about this is it will be nice for penetrating forces because it constantly attacks them. Alright, let's end this. Dun, 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 dun. I tried to survive on there just to see. I'm pretty sure it's an insta-kill. So that is just a showcase of explosives. I will get into the how to actually make all the wiring and stuff and actually make the explosives later on. But yeah. That's all for now. See you guys later. Try as you love.